big boss. My quip is loaded, it's full of alas. I put it in your face and you won't say nada. Vatos cholos, you call us what you will. You say we are assassins, you're dreaming about to kill. It's in my blood to be an Aztec warrior. Go to any extreme and hold no barriers. Chicano, and I'm brown and proud. Want this chingazo, Simona, so let's get down. Right now, in the dirt. What's the matter? You afraid you're gonna get hurt? I'm with my homeboys, my ties, my camaradas. Kicking back, con mi ganga y pa mi no diga nada. You're switching gones, like Al Capone, it. Control a todo, so don't ever try to sweat me. Some of you don't know what's happening, que pasa. It's not for you anyway, cause this is for the raza. Speaking is known as Galo. Y sabes que loco, yo soy muy malo. Tú no sabes nada, your brain is hollow. Been hitting the head too many times with a palo. Still you're trying to act cool, but you should know. You're so cool that I'ma call you a gulo. You're just a peewee, you can't get none ever. You're on the lever. Your own radio doesn't back you up. They just look at your ass and call you a poo butt. And so I look and I laugh and say, ¿qué pasa? Yeah, this is for the raza, raza, raza.
Cowboy says they threw in a cocktail last night. Tell him, cowboy. A hippo and his brother. They threw a cocktail through the window. The old man runs out, and this is the same old man they jumped 2 days ago. He's in this country illegal.
So who's gonna help him if we don't? We're his brothers, man. We're Chicanos. If something like that happened in Marina del Rey, the cops will be there in a minute.
Right.
Excuse me, sir. I beg your pardon, sir. Did someone throw a bomb in your bed, sir? Don't worry. We'll bust him. We'll send him straight to jail. Venice ain't the marina.
So what do you want to do, Cesar?
I want to show them. We call ourselves Los Aztecas. That's a proud thing to be. So how can we let them come down on somebody in our race? No way, man. We show them. What do you think?
Okay. Claro.
Jenny, get out!
Hey, fellas. I was just kidding around, you know? Give me a break. Come on, give me a break, all right?
Oh!
Burning, Vicente. You're the one who wanted to carry a piece. Now use it.
No! Don't shoot me, man.
Put the gun in his mouth and blow his goddamn head off.
Come on, man. Please don't shoot me.
Don't shoot me, man. Come on.
Don't forget.
All right, I won't.
Maybe you can spend the night?
Come early.
I will.
No, it wasn't me. No, it wasn't me. Aggravating. Listen to me.
What's the matter with it?
It won't start.
You want me to take a look at it? I know a little about cars. I won't rip off your hubcaps. Why don't you open up the back? I'll take a look.
Yeah, right. You got it?
Yeah, I got it. Okay, start it up. Turn the key.
I am turning the key.
Wait a second. Okay, try it now. What did you do to this car?
What did I do to it? I didn't do anything to it.
It was just... the deadest automobile I ever saw in my life.
Thanks.
Lock it up. I'll take you home.
Listen, I think I better call my father.
Well, I'll catch you later, all right? Bye.
Bye.
You know, you really shouldn't keep your car here.
I know.
What do you say if I kind of push you over there someplace?
Okay, do you think you can?
Are you kidding? You know who you're talking to?
No.
I'll be your engine, okay?
All right.
Put it in neutral. You like this car?
Yes, I do, very much.
It's nice. How much did it cost you?
I don't know. It was a present. I got it for my 17th birthday.
That's a nice present.
I know.
Hey, I'll send you my bill in the morning.
I didn't want none of the others here. That's why I'm telling you guys first. We're the ones who started the clicker, man. We the... Boy, it's about time, I say. I want John Vicente out, you see. He's a chicken shit dude. I tell him what to do last night. He don't do it. I tell him, stick the piece in the bastard's mouth, blow his head off. He shoots him in the leg instead.
I think we should give him another chance,
man. What for, man? So he can screw up again?
Hey, cowboy. Maybe Cesar's right, you see. We did make the rules.
Damn right, homeboy. If he's an Azteca, then he with us. A toda madre. Or not at all. I tell somebody to do something, I want him to do it. Otherwise, get another president!
Hey, kind of nah. To jump it, Mom.
Yeah. I don't want him in my clique no more. I want you to understand this. I want to make sure you understand this. After today, you're not an Azteca no more. That means you don't come around no more. You don't come no place near us, you hear? You don't tell nobody what we ever talked about. You don't say where we keep our pieces. You just keep your mouth shut. You hear? To us, you don't exist no more. You get in trouble, some other clique, tough shit. You got no more insurance. You understand that?
Says, I swear to God.
Oh, good. El vato, he understand.
Let's go, Emilio. Come on, Emilio. Let's go.
Let's go. Let's go cruise, huh? Let's go get some homegirls. I know this nice one, man.
Community Action Center.
All right, guys, let's go. Hey, where's Cesar?
He had some business, man.
He had some business. I said I wanted to talk to all four of you.
He couldn't make it.
Oh, he couldn't make it. All right, come on, let's go. Hey, Roosevelt, you got those forms?
Venice Community Action Center.
Straight ahead, guys.
Just a moment, please.
Straight ahead, gentlemen. Hey,
Make yourselves comfortable, huh?
Yeah. Call downtown and see who Central has.
Yeah. Well, I told you I'd take care of that one. Yes. Mm-hmm. Well, I'll settle that when I get to the office.
Sure. This is Sergeant Gannett of the police department. He's here because there's a 15-year-old kid in the hospital.
It's a kid who belongs to your gang. His name is...
The club, Sergeant.
His name is Vicente Carranza. Anybody know how he got hurt? Where's Arlino, Mike? You said he'd be here.
He couldn't come, Jim.
He's the leader of your gang, isn't he? This is Cesar Arlino.
He's president of our club, Sergeant.
Well, this Carranza kid. Patrol unit found him in a field behind the airport. His arm was broken, half of his teeth was knocked out. He's in a coma, and the hospital says he may not pull through. Does anybody know what happened? Who do you think did it?
Maybe some other club, Sergeant.
Yeah, from Santa Monica, maybe.
Culver City? Crazy dudes over there.
What about you? You think some other club did it?
That's a possibility.
Do you know what jumping out is?
I've heard that term.
Mike and I both think this Carranza kid was jumped out of the Aztecs. What do you think? He might die. Now, that makes a lot of sense, doesn't it? One of your own brothers dying because of some stupid gang bullshit.
Sergeant, it's a club.
It's a gang, punk. And don't be interrupting me when I'm talking. You didn't invent gang busting. I was a member of the East L.A. Guardians before your mother and father even thought you up. In those days, we called it war counselors. That's right, I was a war counselor. But it's the same bullshit any way you slice it. Was Vicente Carranza macho enough for you today? Did he have enough balls to make it through your line? Well, I hope he has enough balls to make it through the night. Thanks, Mike.
Community Action Center.
I don't know what's worse, a Chicano cop or a nigger cop.
They're all punks, they say.
Okay, we got the law in here again, huh?
Sometimes you guys make me sick, you know that? You guys think you've got it made because you're not 18 yet. You get into a mess. The most you can get is 6 months, and then you're out in the damn streets again.
I did 9 months at that camp.
And you didn't learn much there either, did you?
Hey, Mike, I learned how to read and write English. That's more than I ever learned at school.
Yeah, but that didn't make you any smarter, my friend. Would you like to go back to that camp?
Who the hell cares? Besides, it was easy. I could do 9 months standing on my head.
Yeah, but what happens when you're 18, Diego?
Name's Dagger.
You can write any name you want on that wall. To me, you're still Diego. Do you know what happens when you're 18?
Yeah. His record gets wiped clean. Whatever he done as a juvenile don't matter no more.
They start you from scratch. You start with a clean slate. I mean, just think of that chance. Don't you understand? When are you going to be 18 anyway?
October 21st.
It's next month.
Yeah.
Well, that's when they're gonna start treating you like a man, Diego. Will you be a man by then? Will any of you be men?
I'm the great mechanic, remember?
Yeah, hi.
So what was wrong with it?
Oh, we still don't know. They had to tow it away.
You know, you have to be careful about those garages. Sometimes it's just a loose wire or something. They'll try to sell you a whole new engine.
Yeah, I know. But my father knows this guy. He's worked on the car before.
Okay, then. How are you getting home?
The bus.
You want a lift? What's your name, anyway?
Sarah Lassiter.
Didn't we have art together once?
No, I don't think so.
I think so. I know. Didn't you used to have, like, you know, darker hair?
No. My hair's always been this way.
What's so funny? I know even Chicana girls, they dye their hair. Even niggers. I see niggers with black hair. Would you believe that?
Blacks? Yeah.
Yeah, let me get the door for you.
So what's your name?
Emilio Mendez. That's for Zapata. Emiliano Zapata, big Mexican hero.
Oh, yeah?
Emilio, Emiliano, same thing. There must be over 2 million Mexican kids named after Zapata. Mm. Maybe more. Did you see that movie?
What movie?
Viva Zapata!
No.
That was a good one. Here, this is my car. You want a ride? Here, get in.
Yeah, all right. Thanks.
What are you saying? Do you think I look like Marlon Brando? Around the eyes, look.
No.
Oh, come on. How do you know if I look like him or not?
I didn't even see the movie. I know what Marlon Brando looks like.
No, but I mean in the movie, Zapata. Did you see the movie, Zapata? Oh, forget it. Did you see The Brave Bulls?
No.
That was a good one, too. Ay, toro, toro, toro. That's what I like to be. A bullfighter. Did you know that in Mexico, bullfighters are like movie stars? Yeah. Except I don't think I really want to kill the bull. I just want to fight the bull.
Yeah.
They stick these things all over his back. Is that a contest? I ask you, is that a contest? So how do you like my car?
It's nice. It's
yeah, I know.
New.
I like it.
I like it.
So you want a hamburger?
No, thanks.
You sure?
Yeah, I'm positive.
You thirsty?
No, really.
So anyway, my grandmother, she still lives down there in Mexico. Yeah. She came up here, my mother, when I was pregnant. Well, when my mother was pregnant, I wasn't pregnant.
You were pregnant. Tell me about it.
You're funny. Anyway, my father, he split, and my mother came up here all by herself. I never met my father. I wouldn't even know him if I fell over him. How about you? Your people still together?
My people? Yes, they're together.
What does he do, your father?
He's a dentist.
How about that? Maybe I'll look him up and get my teeth fixed.
No, he's a periodontist, actually.
What's that?
He takes care of gums.
You thirsty?
No.
You Jewish?
What? Am I Jewish, did you say?
She said it. That's the dentist. They're Jewish.
No, I'm not. I don't know what I am, actually. I'm English, I think, and Irish, and Scotch, and maybe a little German.
Well, I'm Spanish, and Toltec, and Nahuac. And maybe a little Chichimecas. You want some ice cream?
You were born here, though, weren't you?
Oh, yeah, right here. Well, not in Venice, actually. I was born in East Los Angeles.
What was that you just did?
What?
This.
This? This, that means I'm from Venice. That's my neighborhood. My barrio, Venice. I love Venice. Man, I never leave Venice. That's my barrio. I love Venice. You want a hamburger?
No, thank you.
No?
Okay. Fine.
My car is nice, huh? But I got my eye on a 68 Riviera. Really sweet car. I'm gonna put on some silver paint panels, you know? Boy, that'd be a smooth ride.
Yeah?
But you see, the problem is that the guy, he wants like $900 more. I figure I could sell my Ford for, I don't know, $2,000. I gotta come up with $900. You might as well say $9,000.
Yeah, great.
Bucks.
Well, listen, Emilio, this is my house.
Nice area.
Yeah, it's nice. Well, listen. Thanks a lot, Emilio.
Oh, that's Emilio. Emilio.
Oh, yes. Emilio.
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 Right.
Okay.
Hey, listen, you wouldn't want to go to a show or nothing, would you?
A show?
You know, a movie. Oh, we were talking about movies before, you know?
Yeah.
Zapata. Yeah, I was thinking maybe, you know, you might really enjoy it.
I don't think so. But thanks a lot, really. for everything.
Why not? Is it because I'm Chicano? Is that it? That's no reason. So what do you say?
Okay.
Okay.
Your cousins are here, Emilio.
Hey, hi. Don't you look pretty?
Hey, Emilio.
Hey, ¿qué puedes decir?
Katie just invited us to her presentación. And your old suit is going to be just perfect for Manuel.
Yeah? You 15 already?
Uh-huh. 2 Saturdays from now.
Okay, you. That's it.
Okay. Remember, September 24th.
We'll be there. Don't you worry.
Thanks.
Care, huh? Gee, I wonder why they call us beaners.
I like beans.
I wish I did. Uh-huh. Yeah, well, that's good, huh? See? Well, did you call Dagger? Call Dagger. Let him know from me, okay? Yeah, thanks for letting me know. I was getting worried. See? I'll catch you later, man.
Who was that?
That was Cowboy.
Cowboy? Who's Cowboy?
Julio Zamora calls himself Cowboy.
Why?
I don't know why, man. He just calls himself Cowboy.
What did he want?
He called to tell me that his cousin Vicente got hurt.
Vicente who?
Vicente got hurt.
I know his mother. How did he get hurt?
He was in an accident, I guess. I really don't know. Anyway, he's gonna be all right.
Your friend Cowboy. Is he in a gang?
No, Charlie, no.
Then why does he call himself Cowboy? I mean, if his name is Julio.
Probably belongs to a club or something. And these guys belong to a club, they give themselves
what
these
club?
Names. I don't know.
Vicente belong to it too.
I don't know.
Is it Los Aztecas? What I see on the walls? Los Aztecas? Because that is not a club, Emilio. That is a gang. Los Aztecas, a gang. Look at me. Swear to me you don't belong to that gang.
I swear.
Swear on the Virgin.
I swear on the Virgin.
Would you like a hot dog? No, I'll take you to a really good hot dog place. So listen, Sarah, you didn't tell me, you know, why.
Because I was curious about the word.
Chicano.
Yes.
So you mean you just went to the library, huh?
Uh-huh. Do you know what it means? It means double-crossed slang.
What? Who told you that?
The book.
That book told you what Chicano means, double-cross? That book That's crazy. Chicano. That's a word of honor and a pride. Get it. Where did you get that book?
I told you, in the library.
You mean you just went into the library and you asked for a book on Chicano?
Yes.
Why?
Because I knew we were going out tonight.
That really pisses me off. That really pisses me off, you know that?
Why?
Because it's like I'm a midget or something. And you went into the library and you got a book on midgets. That's the best hot dog in all of Venice.
It's very good.
I'd say maybe in all of Los Angeles. Right there in your head. So, tell me about that time.
Oh. Well, we just moved from the valley to the marina, right? And I was 12 years old. And this girl was school, and it was Alison.
Starlight filled the evening. We wrote it, and I played it. Something happened. It's so strange, this feeling. Naive notions that were childish. Simple tunes that tried to hide it. But when it comes, we all fall in love sometimes. Did we?
Father's strict?
What
do you think, huh? That's beautiful. So you didn't answer me, you know?
What?
About your father?
Oh.
You know, is he strict or not?
No. He's really okay. I mean, now that we've resolved the Oedipal thing, or Electra, I guess it is with girls.
What?
In any case, we get along fine.
What? What is that?
What?
Electra? What is that? Is that what
Electra?
You said?
Electra was a person in Greek mythology.
What is that? Come here, come here.
The legends? The Greek legends?
Oh, legends. Here, I want you to sit.
Anyway, why do you want to know about Electra?
No, I know about that.
Oh.
I want to know about your father. You know, I want to figure out whether your father raised you strict or not.
I'm not following you.
You see, Sarah, Chicana girls, they raise very strict.
Yeah?
Most of them. Some of them, well, they're raised not so strict. Down in the barrio, guy learns pretty quick who's who and what's what. So that a dude knows how to behave with a girl. You understand that?
Yeah. Comes the dawn.
Whether to, you know.
Yeah.
Or whether to cool it.
So, what you're trying to figure out is...
No, what I'm trying to figure out, you see, if you were restricted or not.
You want to know whether it's going to be trick or treat, right? And here I thought you were beginning to love me for my mind. Okay, well, tell me about these nice Chicano girls.
Never mind, I'm sorry I even mentioned.
No, seriously, I want to know. Do nice Chicano girls kiss, for example?
Yes. They kiss.
Even without a dueña?
Yeah, without a friggin' dueña. Look, Sarah, don't you make fun of me.
Book.
What book?
and very important.
Si. Machismo. What does the book say? Robbery, is it?
Yeah.
I mean, you know that?
Yeah. But Emilio, this way we got a shot at $400 to $500. The other way we just break into a house someplace. And what money we get for that television in Malibu?
$50.
$50, sure.
I think we should go in there with the pieces.
A piece is only to scare him.
You won't use it?
Yeah, if I have to. But he's an old man, Emilio. I stick the gun in his face. And he'll piss in his pants. What do you say?
When did you want to do this?
Tuesday.
Tuesday? It's El Dia 16.
That's the whole idea. They don't expect you in school on Mexican Independence Day. And they don't expect us to hold up no record store either.
Tanto loco.
Mexico. You take me to Mexico sometime?
Yeah, sure. I'll take you to Mexico. Hey. ¿Qué va?
Parents are gonna like you.
What'd you tell them about me?
Nothing, but I will. By Saturday, they'll know all about you.
On Saturday?
You're coming to meet them.
Who said?
I said.
I think I'm a gardener. Sarah, this is Cesar.
Buenas tardes, señorita.
Buenas tardes.
This is Dagger.
Hi.
This is Carlos.
Carlos.
Is that Hal? He's a boxer.
Boxer.
Heavyweight.
Main man, Manuel. He's my cousin.
Hello, Manuel. Yeah. Right.
Hey, everybody. This is Santa.
Hello.
It's my great honor to make your acquaintance.
Hey, look who's here. Dagger. What is it this time?
Well, this time it's a holdup.
Oh, so of course. You come straight to the barrio, huh?
Yep, I come straight to the barrio. The cowboy got himself shot this afternoon, holding up a record store in Santa Monica. Armed robbery is a felony. Now, two of you went in there this afternoon, and one of you got away. Cowboy won't say who it was, but the store owner will.
We've been here at the fiesta all day long.
Right. All day, huh?
Yeah.
Well, we'll just see about that when we get to the station.
You busting us, Sergeant?
There's no bust.
For what?
I'm rounding up as many Aztecs as I can find because I'm going to have a little talk with you at the station, gentlemen. Now, if you don't mind, your cars are waiting outside.
Oh, this is a waste of time.
I've got all the time in the world. Let's go, Emilio.
I don't care which one I use with Cowboy. That don't matter to me. Cowboy behaved with honor. He refused to betray his brothers. Bueno, the store owner will be here. He's gonna look us over. They got a one-way mirror. He can see us, but we can't see him. But that don't matter. When you look in the mirror, stare him down. Make him know he fingers one Azteca, the rest of us come back to get him. You understand? Look at the mirror as if you're looking him straight in the eye. We're brothers.
We're brothers. All of us. Just remember that.
Mariano, come on over here. You, get in the back. Open the door.
Mr. Henderson, just take your time. Look each one over carefully, and if you recognize anybody, let me know.
So all I want you to do is just explain to me how you got involved. I know that you were letting. Did somebody entice you into it?
Are you sure they can't see through this thing?
Well, I'm positive.
It feels like they can. Somewhere in there,
I'm sure you're gonna fit. Just go ahead and explain to me how you got hung up in the whole thing. Loosen up, man.
I've got half the case together. It's gonna go together. You know how they all fall together. Just give me your part. I know it wasn't really
your fault. I know it was just something you got caught up in.
You recognize anybody yet?
You know I'm not gonna back up on you.
Not yet.
Come on, Carlos. You know what's gonna happen. You know what's gonna become of it.
It's all gonna go together. Just tell me about the robbery and how you got involved.
He's not the one.
Now listen, Emilio. I've had Ariano in here. I've had Diego in here. I've had Miguel in here. Carlos in here. And now you're in here. So all the pieces are falling together, Emilio.
Oh, he's
we can't understand each other.
He's not the one.
Well in this investigation.
Are you sure, Mr. Henderson?
So what I want you to do is just let me know how you got involved in it.
I don't remember. I don't recognize anybody. Can I go now? I gotta get back to the store.
Just tell us how you got started. No. You can't take the tough line, though.
Sure.
It's big, serious. Your buddy's lying over there. He's shot up. He's gonna
be okay. Now, where are you gonna stand?
Hello? ¿Quién es?
Hi, Milo. It's Sarah. When did you get home?
Just a little while ago. Because I figured it was too late to call. I didn't want to wake your people. Nothing. The cops are always hassling us. They think anybody's Chicano belongs to a gang. No. No, no, Charlie, no. I don't belong to no gang, Sarah. The store owner came in, and he looked us over, and he didn't recognize anybody.
Are you telling me the truth?
That's the truth. I don't belong to no gang.
All right, I'm sorry. Yeah, I'll see you tomorrow.
Pardon the Jenny a little bit, Abby. How long have you known Sarah?
Just a little while.
Are you in the same class?
Oh, yeah. We both graduated in June.
What are you going to do afterwards?
I'd like to get a job.
What kind of job?
I want to be a mechanic. You see, I like cars. I'm really good with cars.
Yeah, Dad, Emilio's got this 64 that he customized himself. You should see it.
Yeah. I stick with Ford power, you know? I parked it just up the block from your apartment, you know, if you want to see it. You know, if you want to see it.
Is your father a mechanic, too?
My father? I don't know. I never met my father.
Is he here in America? Mexico?
Yes, I think so. I really don't know.
What's that on your hand? Tattoo?
Oh, no, no. I made it myself. With Indy ink, you know? You see these letters here? C-S? That means con safos. That means safe in Spanish.
Looks like a crucifix. You religious?
I don't think this is a crucifix. I really don't know what it is.
Put it on your hands yourself, didn't you?
Oh, yeah. But you see, a lot of guys, they put it on their hands. It's like a superstition, you know? It don't mean nothing.
I see. It don't mean nothing.
No, nothing at all.
This course is fine. Sales look good.
Sarah, maybe we ought to get lunch started.
It's lunch.
Yeah.
Stop her from seeing it, you know. She still listens to me.
You know that won't work.
What makes you so sure?
I know Sarah.
All right, then. From now on, you pick her up at the house. No more street corners.
Yes, sir.
Sarah?
Yeah?
Would you like to come up here and take the helm?
Yes. Thank you, Dad.
There you go. I'm going below to get something to drink. Would you like something?
No, thank you.
Well, what did he say?
I think it's okay.
Well, is it or isn't it?
I think so. I don't know if they're going to invite my mother to supper yet. It's okay.
Safos is supposed to mean free and clear. Safos.
This wall is my place, man. That's my name on it. Whoever crossed it out answers to me.
So, why did Sissa send you, man? I mean, he's such a big man. Why didn't he come himself?
He don't trust you. You crossed out his name, Tigre. You shouldn't have done that.
Don't point at me, man.
There was a treaty between the two clicas. You shouldn't have started this.
He never should mark the wall.
It was nobody's wall.
What was that wall?
Santa Monica.
Yeah, Santa Monica, right. So when Santa Monica became Aztec territory, huh? Santa Monica's no espiritus, man. It's ours. To get that, ours. Since I wrote on it, and we crossed it off. That's all, let's do it.
You crossed it off,
yeah,
Tigre.
I crossed it off. So what?
Tigre, you're a dead man. Cesar says to tell you that. He's gonna waste you, Tigre. He's gonna plant you 6 feet under, man. And something else, Tigre. You tell your president that Luz is spiritus.
Tell me yourself, Emilio.
Hello, Hugo.
What's the matter now, Emilio?
I think you know what the matter is. When Clemente was president of this club...
Clemente got busted in June. I'm president now.
So why don't you take care of your members? You got a jerk like El Tigre here. He goes and he does something stupid.
He didn't do nothing stupid. If we see Venice riding in Santa Monica, we cross it out, man. That's it.
Hugo, you're fooling with Los Aztecas.
It's too bad about Los Aztecas. If they don't want to see their names crossed out, man, you tell them not to ride on the walls out here.
Cesar says no more safe passage. Anybody on Los Espiritus gets caught coming through, he gets jumped.
Then you better stay out of Santa Monica, man. Because the same thing happens here.
Los Aztecas go wherever they want.
Not if the shit is on, man.
He's telling you it's on. That's why I'm here.
Then I think you better get the hell out of here, man. While you can still walk.
What is it?
Your grandmother's dead.
She wants to go home for the funeral.
Sí. Sí, mamacita.
They called from Mexico about an hour ago.
Mama, do you want me to go with you?
Sí, Emilio.
Okay.
Dispénsame, por favor. I just heard the news, señora. I'm so sorry.
Gracias.
Emilio. If you've got a minute, I'd like to talk to you, right?
Sure. Outside.
Con su permiso, señora.
Emilio, did you go to Santa Monica today? Hey, look, I'm talking to you. Is it true you went to Santa Monica today to meet with Los Espíritus?
Look, Mike, what do you want from me?
I want you to stay out of what's coming.
And Charlie, there ain't nothing coming.
Don't Charlie me, eh? Más respeto, mano. You know, Cesar is bragging all over the barrio. He's gonna get El Tigre. He's gonna show Los Espíritus. Stay out of it, Emilio.
I'm an Azteca. I can't stay out of it.
Cowboy's an Azteca, too. And he's going to jail. Cesar's an Azteca, too. And he's talking about killing somebody. Is that what an Azteca's supposed to be?
You want to know?
Yeah.
Okay, I'll tell you, man. It is somebody with honor, somebody with pride in his race. Our race, Mike. We're Chicanos. We're Aztecas. And the two of them together?
Sí, muy macho.
Sí, muy macho. I'm an Azteca, Mike, and that is something.
No, that is bullshit.
To call myself an Aztec? You know how many guys would give their right arms to call themselves an Azteca?
How about calling yourself Emilio Mendez? Okay. How about finding your pride and your honor? And your goddamn manhood in that. Could you try that, Emilio? For once in your goddamn life, try that. Stay out of it, Emilio.
How long have you been gone?
Oh, only 2 or 3 days. I'm just going down for the funeral. I'm really gonna miss you, Sara. You wanna tell me what the matter is with you?
You lied to me. You belong to a gang, Emilio. I asked Carl in my English class.
Alicia,
I'm sorry about your mother. You gonna be here long?
Leave tomorrow. Jerry? This is your son.
She never told you, huh?
Never.
Who'd you think I was?
She said you were a handsome Mexican businessman.
True enough. I run a taxi service here. Gerald R. Kelsey, Mexican Transit System. Drink up, you're not drinking. Don't you drink? How old are you anyway? Wait a minute, don't tell me,
I'll be 18 in May.
You're a good-looking kid, Emilio. You take after your old man. You got a lot of girls up there in L.A.?
I have a girl.
what else she say about me, your mother?
She said you left.
Yeah, I left.
Why?
I didn't want to marry her. She was 16. I was 28. And I didn't want my balls cut off either. I couldn't come back to this town until after her father died. Very big on them. Honor bullshit. These Mexicans, you know. So what do you do up there in L.A.?
I go to high school.
You on any teams? I used to play football in high school. I drifted down here to Mexico after the Korean War. I met your mother. Well, you know, I had to leave.
You could have stayed.
Tell me something. Did you think that I was a Mexican? Did you think that your old man was a greaser?
I didn't know what you were.
Well, you know now.
Father. Yeah? He's an Anglo. Who'd have guessed that, huh? Their guys are almost Aztecas. They've got skin, you know, much lighter than me. They got Spanish blood going back centuries. And me, I got an Anglo father. Mexico is really something beautiful. I didn't even know half the things they did down there. And that's Mexico down there. Mexico. And what the hell does Mexico have to do with me? I was born right here in East Los Angeles, and I got an Anglo father. Mexico, though. U.S. Well, it's like going back maybe 100 years. Said, my father. On the plane coming back, you know, I asked her. I said, why didn't you tell me? Why did you let me believe my father was, I don't know what I thought. Handsome Mexican businessman, that could be anything. She told me she didn't want to confuse me. Oh. She told me she wanted me to be proud of my heritage.
Proud of my language, proud of being Chicano. Confuse me. Well, if I'm not American and I'm not Mexican, then what the hell am I? They tell me I'm Chicano. But they're just selling me a bunch of bull. They're selling me a word about honor and pride. Because I don't even know who I am. Sarah, my father, he's an Anglo. He's a drunk. He's a disgusting of vomit.
I didn't mean to say that.
Milo.
No, Mimi. Some of my cheese and more, huh? Your father. He thinks I'm Pancho Villa, come to steal his daughter. But he doesn't realize. He said, I'm Pancho Ninguno. Pancho Nobody. I couldn't steal you if I tried.
You don't have to steal me, Emilio.
No, huh?
I love you.
I love you, too. I don't know what to do. I know you want me to quit the gang.
Yes.
I know that's what you want. But you see, Sarah, if I quit Los Aztecas, what have I got left?
Me?
And when I lose you, Sarah?
You're not gonna lose me. Why I cannot go to the presentación? I am in mourning.
Yes, I'm sorry, Mrs. Mendez.
You don't have this in your religion, a presentación?
No.
What is your religion?
Presbyterian.
This has Jesus?
Yes.
How long have you known Emilio?
Just a little while.
Did you meet in school?
Yes, we did.
Se lo da con humildad. Brinca ni baila.
Those are all Katie's closest friends. You remember Manuel? You met him at the fiesta. There are 14 of them here because, you see, when you add Katie, that makes it 15. And this is to celebrate her 15th birthday.
Padre, del Hijo y del Espíritu Santo. Cristina Díaz, estás hoy aquí para consagrar tus 15 años de edad y para pedirle a Dios que te proteja y te guíe en todos los caminos de tu vida.
about going out and get some nice fresh air?
Hey, what's the man?
Yes, Dagger.
Can't find my super essay. Emilio! It's okay now.
Say, you want to go out to a party night? I'm an Azteca.
Emiliano! Vámonos!
Don't go.
Emiliano!
Sarah, come on.
We're gonna dig everything up.
We're gonna
throw everything at him.
Ain't they can mess with our honor, man? No. Think they can come here the night of Katie's presentation?
Mess up her party. Mess up our guys.
No way.
Man.
They wrong.
They got to know who we are and what we are. We're los Aztecas. That's who we are. And we're Chicano. That's what we are.
That sucker's a cannon, man. Look at that.
I'm going to put a hole in that chicken shit dig at his head.
Hey, remember that time with those Cover City dudes?
Yeah.
Shot Petey, though.
Yeah, we came down with more shit.
Oh, man.
Yeah, hey, some of you guys don't remember this.
Yeah, they shot Petey at the school, man. And he was minding his own business, right?
Hey, he was only walking along. They jumped.
Man, they blew his arm right off.
We got those bastards.
Yeah, man, we got in the cars, man. And we went after them, man. Remember, Emilio.
Finals Cover City, dude.
You don't want to say. We got him against the wall.
I hit him in the head with a baseball bat, and his head's bleeding all over that goddamn place.
Boss, I ran his stomach to see.
He's holding himself.
Asshole can't believe it is.
He can't believe he's got a knife holding him.
I show them out to him.
We gonna show him tonight. Tonight, we show Santa Monica.
All right, let's go.
The heat comes down, we show them too, man. Right. We're gonna burn those bastards out, man. We go straight to the pier, man. Hey, there's nobody there? Burn down the whole pier. Hey, we go look for them in the street. I wonder if Digger is with them. If Digger is gonna eat this piece, man. He's gonna have a hole in the back of his head when I'm all over the wall. We're gonna claim that whole barrio for ourselves. Los Aztecas! Los Aztecas! Los Aztecas!
I'm gonna kick ass, man. I'm doing this to my face.
We're gonna give it to them all, man.
Kill them!
Los Aztecas! Los Aztecas! All right, Tiger, you, me, Carlos, in Emilio's car.
Simon.
Go to Santa Monica! What's the matter?
I'm not going.
What?
I'm not going, you say, sir.
Come on. What? What the hell's the matter with you, is it?
I don't want to go with you, Cesar.
Those bastards crossed out my name, Bato.
So what? So they crossed your name off a wall. Where does it end, Cesar? We get them. They get us. We get them again. And for what? For a name on a wall? No. No, Vatons. No, Cesar. I want something else. Not this.
You're chickening out, huh?
No.
No? Now, what do you call it, man? You're chickening out, man! You got no balls! You're a pussy! You're a little sissy!
You have it your way. I'm still not going with you, Cesar.
Thank you.
chickened out.
You remember Espanol? They don't think he's gonna make it.
They won't try to hurt you, will they?
No, are you sure? Yeah, don't worry.
Emilio, please tell me. What will they do to you?
They'll jump me out.
What does that mean?
Sarah, there are just some things you'll never understand.
You. I'd like you to step up on a curb, please.
Sure.
I want to ask a few questions. What's this?
I cut my hand.
Where do you live?
I live in Venice.
What?
I live in Venice.
Where are you going now?
My car.
I can't hear you.
I said I was going to my car. This is my car right here. You, mind telling me what I did?
I just want to talk to you.
Do you mind telling me what I did?
I want to talk to you.
Look, leave him alone. He's a friend of mine. He just left me. I live right here in this building, 1220, right here. My name is Sarah Lassiter. You can look on the mailboxes. He's a friend of mine. He's my friend.
Now take it easy, Mace.
He's a friend of mine.
Come on, Jake.
Does this happen a lot? Hey, wait a minute.
Sarah, you told them that I was your friend. What if you had to tell them that I was your boyfriend? What if you had to say that we're engaged, or this is my husband, this man here is my husband? What would you do then, Sarah?
I'd say what had to be said.
Would you?
Emilio, I did say it. They knew exactly what I was talking about.
Never gonna work in a million years.
Emilio, I love you. That's all that matters.
I love you too. But how can this work? Don't you see that? What are you doing here?
How did you find out where I'd
be? Call Katie. She told me you'd be here. Emilio, don't do this.
I have to.
No. You don't have to do anything you don't want to do.
Sarah, go home. Just get the hell out of here.
You to understand this. I want to make sure you understand this. After today, you're not an Azteca no more. That means you don't come around no more. You don't come no place near us, you hear? You don't tell nobody what we ever
save
talked
your
about.
Breath, Cesar. I know it by heart.
I think you better save yours, maybe. We're gonna break every bone in your body, Emiliano. You get up off the ground again, it's un milagro. You know why we're doing this? Because you have disgraced los Aztecas. And when you disgrace us, you disgrace the Chicano people.
It's bullshit. They're not the same thing, Ese.
I'm gonna beat the shit out of you anyway, Ese. And then I'm personally gonna kick your ass through that line.
Good. You do it.
Emilio! Emilio! Vengase! Come on! You want to get out of our clica with honor and pride?
I'm already out. I have nothing to prove to you.
Only to myself.
yourself.
Boy.
What the hell's wrong here?
This is the way you wanted it. Huh, Emilio?
Yes! Oh.
About our people out there working, surviving with pride and dignity. That's raza.
It's all going down this year. My lack's in gear and I wiped off my tattoo tears. A lot of things have changed since 90. I got a lot more homeboys in hand than behind me. And this time you just can't stop it. No telling what might happen when your kids get a copy of the 95 remix. We in the casa. I did it for the raza. Because it's all brand new, it's updated. You see, my Cherokees are lacking, my spokes are gold plated. I'm eating side to side, there's a lump in my throat, but I just can't swallow my brown pride. I'm like a nigga with a snake in his mouth, and a brown fist represents frost in the house. Coming back hard on the rap scene, it's all about the red, white, and green. Cause I'm proud of the color of my skin. You see, I'm kinda like De La Hoya. I'm filled with the spirit of an Aztec warrior. And that means you better not mess with me. This is Frost, the capital DSC. I'm hitting switches like back in the video. I'm that same fool that you seen 5 years ago. I still cruise, I pay my dues. And the only thing new is some more tattoo. It's that Mexican sound that makes it brown. I'm stopping in my Nikes and I'm all creeps down. Out in El Paso, up through Chicago, even in Manhattan, they begging for a Latin. Cities like Miami is waiting for another jam. I rock Mexico, but call it the motherland. Yeah. Came up with a solution. solution, and the answer is brown revolution. So pump your fist to this and wave your Mexican flag and be proud that your khaki sag. I'm here to set the record straight, to clean up the slate. All player haters headed upstate. They hate to see me bouncing through East Los, or cooling in my house on the hill on the West Coast, or hanging with the vet that I know OGs, and hearing all the stories of the 70s, like how the boulevard used to be, and how they had values in 73. But now we're living in a new era, and surviving in the 90s is sheer terror. Some of you don't know what's happening in Pasa. It's 1995, and this is still for the Ross.
Del Taco, you're hot stuff.
Del Taco makes four kinds of burritos.
Hot stuff.
A soft tortilla filled with lots of good things.
Hot stuff.
Tell us how you want it, hot or mild.
Ooh, hot stuff.
It's our California flavor. The freshest taste.